Welcome to the Swan Show, your weekly update on all things Swansea City. Coming up this week,
we have a chat with informed defender Mike Van Der Hoorn.
But first, we go behind the scenes with Swansea City's under-23s.
Generally speaking, how would you assess this season? It was a big step up for you, wasn't it? It's gone pretty well, though.
Yeah, it has. We've enjoyed it. I think the first 2 to 3 weeks of the season, it was clear that, you know, we'd have to change one or two things and adapt the way that, A, the players played. Our system and the way that we like to play and possession is all very well. But what we are finding as well is, you know, the teams, when they get a chance in this league, when they play with experienced players, you know, good elite young players, which is fair to say are probably the best in Europe, if not the world, some of them, you know, you have to manage that a little bit better. And in fairness to everybody that's been involved, the coaching staff, the whole staff around the 23s have been excellent with regards to their recovery, the way that we look after them and prepare them sports science wise, and the players themselves deserve a lot of credit, because what we've asked of them, they've stepped up to the plate and delivered. And now we're in a position where, you know, I guess you could say that we've confirmed our status in this league for next year, which is important, because then you have, you know, the 18s that are obviously coming up to us. They're now going to be competing in that environment as well.
Is it about winning games for you, or is it about seeing, as you touch on there, two lads went and made their debuts against Notts County last week, didn't they? Connor Roberts has had a good few weeks, hasn't he, with the first team. Is that what it's about for you?
That second bit is really, really important, but you know, the development, the winning games, they nearly all come under the same umbrella. But you know, to get those two boys make their debuts in the FA Cup, and obviously Connor come back and play for the first team, that gives everybody a great boost too.
You know, when one of our own, if you like, or one that's been with us for 2 years or more, manages to make that grade, it's really, really pleasing, because, you know, there's a lot of work and you know, hard work and effort that goes in by a lot of staff behind the scenes that nobody sees. So it's really pleasing.
And as players, all your teammates, the dream is, of course, to go and play for the first team. You've had a little taste, haven't you, and a few loan spells elsewhere, but that's still the target for you?
Yeah. I think it's a target for everybody here. We all want to be in the first team. We're all raring to go and trying to get ourselves prepared for the first team, really, and hopefully that chance comes. Obviously, Dan James and Adnan now have had the chance, and hopefully there's more to come for other players too.
How are you feeling? You still on cloud nine after making your first team debut and scoring a fine goal last week?
Yeah, I think so. It's given me a lot of confidence, especially training the first team and in around the boys. And I think today and all the other games that I've played now I've got a lot of confidence from it.
What was it like? It must have been a good feeling just to get on the pitch, never mind get that goal.
Yeah, it was a great feeling. I think I stood on the sideline for a good 20 minutes before I came on, because the ball won't go out of play. But no, I think it's what you dream as a boy. And oh yeah, it was great experience.
But encouraging signs under Carlos Carvajal that he's prepared to look at younger players and throw them in.
Yeah, it's great to see. And that's, we only know if we're good enough if we have that opportunity. And it's great to see that the lads have had opportunities, and hopefully there's more to come.
I think last season when I was here and we didn't have no right back, and I was a bit disappointed not to be chucked in by the previous gaffer. But this time, obviously, he showed faith in me, speaking to Alan Curtis and people around the club. And I'll be always thankful for him to give me that chance.
Getting that little first taste of the first team, same with Adnan Maric, and Connor's had a good few weeks, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Must just drive you on to get even more now, doesn't it?
I think so, yeah. I think a lot of the boys have obviously looked at that as well, as getting our debuts, and thought they could, they've got a chance too. I think this gaffer's lets a lot of the young boys train with them. Even the 18s have been up a lot, so I think he's been really good with them. Just gives that belief of everyone can do it. So.
And you were at Manchester United, weren't you, when you were a younger lad? What's it like learning your trade at Swansea?
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I come in every day, and and I couldn't ask for anything more, really. It's great to see the boys are great, and the coaches are fantastic. So we just want to learn every day and get ourselves ready for the next opportunity and the next adventure.
Academy, you know, deserves a big pat on the back, and the fact that recently, obviously, Dan James and Adnan also got an opportunity to go up with the first team and play is testament to that. And obviously, Ollie McBurney now going out on loan, and also having his full league debut recently, and clearly Connor, who's a local boy, who's probably out of all of them the one who's been at the academy for the longest. Is it's great to see. That's one of the reasons why we're in the game.
How long have you been at the Swans now, Paul?
I think it's 10 years since I was 10 years old, so it's been a long time coming, to be fair. Obviously, like I've said in previous interviews, the chance to play for the first team has always been in the back of my mind, and it's come now, but still a long way to go, and hopefully I can cement my place and in the future get many more minutes under my belt.
Is it Neath you from? Is that where you were brought up?
Yeah, I'm from Crynant, if anyone knows that, in the Dilys Valley, but I live in Neath now at the moment, so I'm a proper Valleys boy, to be fair. Not many people play football around there, but it's not far from where Ben Davis lives, to be fair, the 10 minutes, so
Bit of an inspiration for you, I can imagine, Ben.
Yeah, definitely, obviously, coming up when he made his break, everyone's like, oh, when's it all going to happen? And I always used to turn around and say, it might never happen, it's a tough job to do, and he was just lucky and put in the performances he did. But now my chance has come, and I think I'm doing myself justice.
What does it mean to you to wear the Swans badge on your chest?
Yeah, it's unbelievable. You know, obviously, it wasn't that massive crowds in the Liberty, but when they sing my name and he's one of our own, it just makes the hairs on back and neck stand up. Not that I've got much there, but it's brilliant to just see them sing my name, and obviously, hopefully, it can continue.
And the two names that spring to mind when you think of Swansea's youth products over the last decade or so, Joe Allen, Ben Davis. Are we likely to see more like that anytime soon, do you think?
We hope so. That's the plan. I mean, obviously, we have to keep working. We have to keep producing good periodised training, good sports science programmes. We have to look after them from a nutritional point of view and educate the young men, not just the player, but the young man. You have to educate the young man on the importance of certain values and behaviour and the way to do things to enable him to have the best chance of succeeding. But are we likely to see them? I mean, that's why we're all here. That's what we want to try and achieve, and we won't stop trying our best to do that.
The Swans made it 5 straight home wins in all competitions, courtesy of last weekend's battling victory over Burnley. Ki Sung Young scored his first goal of the season late on to lift Carlos Carvajal's team up to 16th in the Premier League table. Off the field, Angel Rangel underwent surgery on his abductor problem, with the Swans club skipper set to be sidelined for 6 weeks. Wilfried Boney and Leroy Fair have also had successful operations on their long-term injury problems. Mike, thanks for joining us. You've got to be pretty pleased with how life is going for you at the moment, haven't you?
Yeah, of course. These are the nicer days to be a Swansea player, and I think we have a great run, and we don't want to stop right now.
You've had to be patient, haven't you? Since you joined the club last year, I think 11 appearances.
Yeah.
I know you were a little bit disappointed not to play more, but this season you've played a lot more football, and certainly since the new manager came in, you've been a regular, haven't you? So you must be pleased.
Yeah, it's why you come here. I think for everybody who's a player and wants to play, and yeah, for me it's no difference. And I think we have a great run, and that's good when I'm part of it.
And as well as being good on the ball, Mike, you're a big lad. You like the physical battle, don't you, in English football?
Yeah, of course. That's part of my quality, I think. I'm not afraid of anyone, and I just see the ball and opponent, and I don't care who it is. And just, it has to go over the line or just. But I think I'm always fair. I'm not really picking up yellow or red cards. So just I'm always trying to be fair. And sometimes you miss the ball, and then. The food is in the way, but the lads sometimes complaining about it as well. But I'm training, but sometimes it's good to to do some physical as well.
You make strong tackles and strong challenges on the training field as well, do you?
Yeah, I think you prepare for a game, and sometimes you need to practice it on the training and. Yeah, sorry for the guys. Then, as long as they're not getting injured or something, then I think then it's fair.
Yeah, they're not complaining too much, are they?
No, I think they. Yeah, in the beginning I have maybe in the beginning, but now they look back and then they say, oh, it's me. So then they
understand.
They accept it.
Do you think? I remember speaking to you early last season, Mike, when you first came. Do you think you're a better player now than you were when you arrived?
For sure. I think the first half was a little bit difficult. I think with the two managers who were there, but I think especially with Paul Clement as well, he really made me accept. I didn't play, but he made me on training. The training was so good. And, he may be a better player as well, and I think now last half year I feel stronger. I feel just more ready to play every game. And of course I didn't play every game, but I played quite a lot. I think first half, and but now I'm just feeling like it's getting better and better. And it starts to if you play like 5, 6, 7 in a row, then you feel stronger. And I hope now, I found my spot in the team.
Yeah, I mean, I think you played in 9 of the 11 games under Carlos Carvajal, so you must be enjoying life under him too.
Yeah, just only I missed Watford and the.
Was it Wolves?
My hamstring was a little bit tight then, but pleased with this 2 months, I think.
FA Cup this weekend. Yeah. Obviously, Premier League is the big thing, staying in the Premier League, but do you want to do well in the Cup as well, don't you?
Yeah, of course, it's getting really close now till the end of the, so, and I think we have had some good draws, but still, Sheffield away is also, I think, a strong team. Mm-hmm. I think they won last match. And, I think it's a big challenge, but, it's not impossible. So, if you survive this round, you're getting close to the end goal.
It's a famous competition, isn't it? Yeah, that is the FA Cup. When you were growing up in Holland, something you heard about?
I think it's broadcasted like worldwide. So I think it's one of the best cups in the world. Mm.
And their league, meanwhile, things going really well. Another win against Burnley the other day. Are you feeling confident now that you can? That you can survive, stay in the league?
Yeah, I think especially against Burnley. I think we waited for the goal so long, and I saw the team just keep on pushing and never give up. And I think that's how we are now. I think if it's Leicester, we don't give up. Especially for the first 20 minutes, we had it with a hard game, but then we turn it around. And I think that's the big achievement we have now.
And for you, hopefully. Stay in the team for the rest of the season. That's the aim.
Yeah, of course. We have 3 centre backs, and also Kau is doing very good on training and even the cup games. So, we just you have to keep sharp, because otherwise the other guy will step up.
But you want to play in the cup also?
Yeah, of course. I want to play every game. What comes. So I think I'm fit and I'm ready for every game.
Great stuff.
All right, thank you.
Hope it keeps going well
for
you.
Mate.
Cheers, Mike.
Cheers.
Thanks a lot.